Field for the coin toss. We've got a full house of 50,000 plus on hand today. There you see Giles and Brad White, number 74 for Texas Tech, along with Perry Morin. And referee Frank Shepard with the coin toss. The wind, as we told you in the pregame, is whipping from south to north at about 20 to 25 miles per hour. Actually, it's a swirling type wind when you get down on the field. But I think if you take the south end zone, it will be to your advantage if you're a kicker. So let's see the decision rest with one of those seven players on the field. Texas, it looks like. Has won the toss and will defend that south end zone. Ray Auburn, they will kick the football.
Not really a surprise. I tell you, I think one of the things that may have been a factor, Coach Akers was watching Telchik punt before the game, and he was really having a difficult time. So I've got to think that that was a big part. As good a defense as they're playing, make Tech make a mistake. If not, get good field position going into the win.
And, of course, you see the Red Raider making circles around the football field every time Texas Tech scores. Happy Six will take a tour around Jones Stadium. There's Happy. Just prior to the coin flip today, Texas Tech All-American Gabriel Rivera was introduced during the pregame ceremonies. There he is, Senior Sachs, first trip to Lubbock since suffering that paralyzing automobile accident in Pittsburgh back on October the 20th, 1983. And he has been in Lubbock for a couple of days. And he looks in pretty good shape, Ray Auburn. Not when he was terrorizing the Rice Owls when you were coach.
I tell you, the loss, but he was becoming a real, real good football player when that happened to him. But it's just a classic example of what can happen to you. Better enjoy life every day.
Let's take a look now, if we can, at the game officials today. The referee will be Frank Shepard. The umpire will be John Gaston. There they are. The linesman will be Bob Jones. The line judge, Walt Coleman. The field judge, Mike Wetzel. And the back judge, Randy McAnally. But the referee today will be Frank Shepard, and he is a veteran of quite a few of the Southwest Conference wars. The big question for everybody here at Jones Stadium, Ray Auburn, can Texas Tech pull off an upset, something that nobody else has been able to do this year?
Well, I tell you, Bill, I think that they're going to have to move the football with some consistency, and at the same time, as you mentioned in the pregame show, avoid the big hit by the Texas team. Kevin Nelson's capable of breaking the long one. Duhon, Epps in the kicking game. I think all of those things that Tech's going to have to be very concerned about. And then they're going to have to be able to move the football to maintain possession, keep it away from Texas.
A phenomenal record. The Longhorns now unbeaten in 23 straight regular season games going all the way back to 1982 and beginning with that 27-0 victory over Texas Tech, which happened right here 2 years ago. In fact, Texas leads this series 27-6, but the Red Raiders have given the Longhorns trouble in Lubbock during recent years. And they're hoping to give it to them again, as you see Jeff Ward getting ready to kick off. And back deep for Texas Tech will be number one, Charles Simpson, and number 34, Keith Henderson.
It's a great atmosphere for college football right here, Bill. Sellout crowd, people stand there, wear a lot of red, a lot of orange. Ought to be a good one.
Jeff Ward gets his toe into it, and it'll go 5 yards deep in the end zone. He's going to bring it back out. That's Charles Simpson, and he breaks through a big hole to about the 20-yard line. Had he not hesitated, he may have made more yardage, but he hesitated just briefly in the end zone, and that gave Texas enough time for the penetration to get there. Let's set the offense for you now for Texas Tech. The offensive line, it's a dandy group. Joe Walter, Joe McMeans, Jim McIntyre, Aubrey Richburg, and Jeff Keith. Buzz Tatum, the tight end, along with Aaron Cassie, Freddie Wells, Robert Lewis, they're good ones. Charles Simpson and Troy Smith, the wingback. Smith and Tatum, good wide receivers. Cassie on the first play. Handoff up the middle and a gain all the way to the 30-yard line. For Texas Tech. And close to a first down. Goes Robert Lewis. Set the defense now. McKinney, Bronner, DeGreat, Heathcock, Telchik will be the punter. Ty Allert, Tony Edwards, and June James along the front are the linebackers. and Jerry Gray, Braggs, Lott, and Tillman in the defensive backfield. I formation for the Red Raiders. Cassie to throw, and he's intending it out to James McGowan, number 38, out of Lindale, a 5'10", 190-pound freshman, and it was out of his reach.
James McGowan, sort of a surprise starter.
Well, he is, because I thought we'd see Robert Lewis or Timmy Smith in there, but that's not so. Aaron Cassie is starting back there with Freddie Wells and James McGowan.
Sid Chambers has apparently been moved out by Jeff Keith at right tackle, which should strengthen their football team. Sid Chambers is a pretty good football player.
Cassie fakes it and keeps it for the draw across the 35 to the 37. Tony DeGray and Bill Hethcock in on the tackle for Texas, but not before a pretty good pickup of about 7 yards. A little misdirection there.
Just a little step fake to the fullback, giving him option looking and going back away from it. And Texas pursues pretty well. He found a seam back behind the left tackle.
Well, it has to be tough for Aaron Cassie to come in as a freshman. Bruce Parkins into the lineup now for Tech. And coming wide will be Charles Simpson. Handoff to the man in the back, and that's Tony DeGreat. Bulldogs him down at about the 38-yard line, and it's going to be short for a Texas Tech first down. So we will see the punter now for Texas Tech, Dennis Vance. Vance coming in with a 39-yard punting average.
Texas got a 9-man front, that's giving him a rush look.
Michael Felt, number 47, back deep for Texas, and they went after it. And he had to rush the kick, and it's going to be out of bounds, and it may have gone only about 10 or 15 yards. Let's see. So a big break there for Texas.
Brought everybody a lot of pressure and into the wind at the same time.
The offense for Texas, a big, big front. Gene Chilton at 295, Wright, Steelhammer, Chester, and Stewart. Keep an eye on Brent Duhon at wide receiver and Bill Boyd Bryant for Texas. And, of course, William Harris, the big tight end, always dangerous. Bill Boyd Bryant coming wide to the left, Duhon to the right. I formation. Handoff up the middle to Terry Orr, and he's going nowhere. Tim Crawford and Brad White in on the tackle. White's the veteran out of Tahoka. 6'7", 236, and he leads this team with 5 sacks and 51 tackles on the year. There you see Crawford, Riggs, White, Byers, Kinsey, Hastings, Giles, and Jones.
Bill, they substitute quite a bit up front, keep them fresh in order to get pressure.
Artis Jackson now in the game for Texas Tech. Second down and about 8 for Texas. Hand off in the backfield to Kevin Nelson as he gets to the 45, to the 47. And look at all of the black jerseys led by Brad Hastings and Artis Jackson. Hastings with 71 tackles for Texas Tech and one interception on the season. He's 6'3", 230 out of Arlington, and he's a dandy.
Here comes Artis Jackson out of the ballgame. He's 300 pounds. They put him in at the nose in and went into a three-man front look with three down linemen with Artis Jackson at the nose.
Todd Dodge at the controls, Kevin Nelson, Terry Orr in the split backfield. Third down and 5 for the Longhorns. Bill Boyd Bryant in motion. Hand off to Nelson. He's got running room if he wants it. He gets across the 50 into Tech territory. I don't know if he had enough for the first down. It will be close.
They either got a clipping call, Bill, illegal use of the hands out here on the corner by Bill Boyd Bryant, the motion man inside, or an illegal block. Holding. They got the holding call.
So referee Frank Shepard will call Texas Tech over there to talk it over. I wouldn't be surprised to see the Red Raiders march it back. Let's see if we can see the holding here, Ray.
Okay, Bill Boyd Bryant comes in at the bottom of the screen in motion. You can see him crack back, and I think he grabbed as he felt like he was losing the Riggs kid on the play.
Kevin Nelson, who was running with the ball there, is the freshman out of Dulles High School, 5'9", 183. He was inserted into the starting lineup about 3 games ago. and he's added a lot of speed to this Texas attack. Let's listen to Frank Shepard. So it'll be third down, and let's call it right at 15 yards for Texas. Keep an eye now on the wide receivers. Brent Duhon's a good one, but the big money man for Texas has been William Harris.
Tell you, one thing important here is the pass rush of Texas Tech. They've gone into an odd man front. Look like they're playing man coverage.
Make a reverse for Dodge. Here comes Tech, and they've got a fumble. It's a loose ball at the 15-yard line, and the Red Raiders have it. Ronald Byers, number 77.
Bill, there's a flag down up in the line of scrimmage. I believe it's holding against Texas, which will be declined and give Tech the football.
That's the call, and Texas Tech has a first down on the Texas 15-yard line. So a turnover gets the Red Raiders going, and that's something Fred Akers did not want, Ray Auburn, to get this crowd into the football game.
Right, the wind, they take the wind, kick off, play in field position football, and then make a mistake like that. Important thing here is Texas Tech needs to get something on the board.
Troy Smith is flanked out to the left. Freddie Wells, James McGowan in the backfield for the Red Raiders. In their black home uniforms with silver pants, Cassie. He's got a man open in the end zone. Can he get it to him? No, he can't. Well, he had his big tight end, Buzz Tatum, all alone at the back of the end zone. James Lott was the closest Texas man to him.
Bill, that's a good call by Jerry Moore and his staff. They got a big break. They try to hit him for the big play right off the bat. Tatum was open. The ball was thrown a little bit high. Good play fake inside. Two tight ends, one wide receiver.
Bruce Parkins and Troy Smith now both in the lineup for Texas Tech. Freddie Wells, McGowan in the... Well, now the only one back there is Freddie Wells. In motion goes Smith. Cassie wants to put it up again. He's got a man at the 10-yard line, and Troy Smith drops it. Well, he had it.
He was there. The ball was well thrown. It just, I think Troy Smith looked back upfield for just a second to see where Jerry Gray was, which a lot of people will be guilty of that over the year. And as he turned his head back, the ball was there, and he just didn't catch it. Didn't concentrate on the football.
James Lott, Stephen Braggs, Jerry Gray, and Tony Tillman. It'll be third down now and 10 from the 15. Again in motion goes Troy Smith. Cassie to pass. Big Texas rush. And bowling in there is number 87, James McKinney. Well, McKinney has 49 tackles on the year, 5 sacks, make it 6 now. But the big statistic on McKinney, Ray, is he's pressured the quarterback 24 times this year.
That was a good job by James McKinney. And at the same time, Blake Brawner from the other side caused Cassie to pull up, which allowed McKinney to make the hit from the backside. So it was really a team effort there. McKinney was coming hard, but Blake Brawner pulled him up from his left in order for McKinney to make the sack from the right side.
That time, Texas Tech had to call a timeout to get Roland Boswell in the game. They did not have enough players. They only had 10, so a costly timeout now for the Red Raiders. Ricky Gann will be in the game, kicking from his own 32-yard line. So it will be a field goal attempt of 42 yards. And Gann, after, well, not an impressive performance last season, has really come on strong this year. He's kicked 12 of 18 field goals, 13 of 14 extra points for 49 points on the season. Ricky Gann has a heck of a leg. You know about it.
Yeah, he kicked one against us when he was a sophomore down at Rice Stadium with about 25 seconds left to beat us. He's been in some pressure situations. I don't think pressure bothered him. The wind swirling may be the biggest difficulty he'll face right here on this kick.
Well, of course, this is his home turf, too, so the wind swirling down there, I'm sure he's had to kick into it several times before, so we'll just wait and see. Of course, having to call a timeout makes him have to wait around a little more.
Well, yeah, something that they don't want to do, but they need to get some points out of this fumble recovery.
Brian Brock will be holding for the Red Raiders. The ball will be put down at the 32-yard line. Gann gets plenty of leg into it. If it's through there, and it is. So So Happy Six makes a tour around the Jones Stadium AstroTurf as the Texas Tech Red Raiders draw first blood. 3-0 over the Texas Longhorns with 10:42 left to play in the first quarter. And not a real impressive drive, but a big turnover.
Yeah. I wonder if that guy riding the horse is on scholarship.
Yes, he is.
Huh? If he is, that's a scholarship I'd like to have.
Zurich LaRiere. I'd hate to be riding around that AstroTurf on a rainy day, however.
I've seen the day when we could have killed that horse when we played up here, running around so much.
He had to eat a lot of oats.
Oh, huh? Yeah. They changed horses at halftime.
Well, the one thing there, a good thing for the coaching staff as far as Texas Tech is concerned is getting on that scoreboard first. But a big thing for Texas is they prevented 7 points and made them settle for 3.
Good job by their defense coming up with a big play with McKinney with the sack and putting them out of what is considered a chip shot gimme field goal. Rick again kicked the ball well, but you know they prevented what would be considered just a chip shot or an easy field goal. A big boost for the Tech football team, I think.
Kelvin Epps will be back deep for Texas, standing at about his 10-yard line, along with Tony Tillman. And Gann will kick it off. Texas Tech leading it 3-0, 10:42 left to play in the first half. And he kicks a squibber along the AstroTurf. It may have been touched by a Texas player, so somebody better get on it back in the end zone, and they let it run through the end zone and out.
Well, that was a good job by Rick again. With the wind blowing the way it is, he didn't want to kick the ball up high. He squib kicked it. The Texas up man elected to let it go by him. Nobody handling. They get the ball on the 20. Good coverage also by the Tech special team.
So Todd Dodge comes trotting in to run the Texas attack. He'll have Kevin Nelson, Terry Orr in the backfield. Brent Duhon, Bill Boy Bryant flanked out wide with William Harris, the big tight end at 235, number 95. Also a valuable pass receiver. Dodge, handoff to Nelson, and he's going nowhere. Mike Kinsey, number 83. Penetrated in that time, and Nelson, if anything, lost a yard.
Bill, I wouldn't be surprised to see Texas go up on top with the football here in this series. They've got to win. They've got to have something good happen to them. The momentum is riding with the Texas Tech Red Raiders right at this point.
Kinsey, the strong linebacker, 6'2", 226. He's a junior out of Brownwood. There you see that big Texas offensive line. Gene Chilton on left tackle at 295. Greg Wright, 250. Steelhammer, 254. Second down. Again, Nelson at the 22. A gain of maybe 2 before Artis Jackson closes in along with Tim Crawford, Mark Rothblatt. Jackson's a big one. He's a rangy freshman, 6'5", and, well, 300 pounds out of Dallas South Oak Cliff. And there goes the wave.
When it gets to the Texas group, watch, they don't, well, they did it this time. They got booed a minute ago for not participating.
There you see the north end zone. We'll show you that a little later. It's all grass enclosed, but it's covered completely by Texas Tech students. Third down and 8. Now for Texas. Draw play. Dodge, 25, and he stretches out to the 27, and that will not be enough for a first down. Brad Hastings, the middle linebacker for the Red Raiders, wrapped him up. So Texas Tech forces the Longhorns to punt.
It's a good series for Tech. Maintaining their momentum. Good job by their defense.
John Telchik will be back to deep to punt. He comes into the game with a 43.8 average. This time he gets a wobbler off and it hits at the 30. He's going to let it roll. Look out. It could go down and it goes all the way into the Red Raider end zone. Wow, what a leg. For John Telchik as he punted that the length of the football field. A candlelight Christmas cowboy style will attract thousands again this year to Texas Tech University's unique Ranching Heritage Center. For the public, it's a free stroll down the yesteryear path, visiting century-old ranch homes where volunteer family groups prepare for the holidays. Singing carols by the campfire, a cowboy Santa, puppet shows, All coming your way December 4th, 5th, and 6th at the Texas Tech Ranching Heritage Center. First and 10 for the Red Raiders. Again, Cassie tries the draw play, gets maybe a couple before he runs into Bill Hefcock and big number 94, Ralph Darnell.
Tech needs to move the ball up the field a little bit, get him some working room.
Are you surprised, Ray, by the backfield combination of Freddie Wells and James McGowan
by
Tech?
Very much so. Very much so.
Flip back this time to Wells. He's trying to go wide. Here comes that Texas pursuit, and they've got him for no gain, and look who it is. Number two, the All-American, Jerry Gray.
McGowan.
Correction, that was McGowan that time.
Had a little trouble feeling the ball, it looked like, which slowed him down to getting outside, and just wasn't able to maintain it. I think Jerry Gray was there when he got ready to turn the corner. He never really got his shoulder pad turned up the field.
Charlie Simpson checks into the Tech lineup. Tony Griffin becomes the fifth defensive back for Texas, checking in place of Ty Alec.
Look for a stunt here out of the Texas front. Bring a backer or a defensive back possibly to bring. There's a backer coming, June James.
Cassie looking for the man. He's got his man, Freddie Wells, who made a great catch at about the 24-yard line, but it was smelled out early by Texas number 62, June James.
Show you kind of athlete June James is. See him there in your screen. He jumps upfield, hits a tackle, hits a back coming at his feet, and there he is making the play.
Ooh.
I tell you now, those kind of guys make a good football coach.
Dennis Vance standing back inside his 10. That's Kelvin Epps for Texas back on the Longhorn 35-yard line.
Here they come again. Nine-man rush.
Epps decides to let it go, and it gets a Texas bounce. It could have gone down about 10 or 15 more yards. So Texas Tech kills it at the 32. Texas will try to get something going in just a moment with 6:34 left in the first quarter. We'll be back with more in a moment. This is Home Sports Entertainment.
Akeem is on the team, and your front row seat is waiting. Houston Rockets basketball on Home Sports Entertainment.
Not great field position. They'd like to have gotten better, but that's not bad considering the wind. I think that was a 44-yard punt. Epps should have fielded the football, but he let it bounce. Fortunately for Texas, it didn't take a deep bounce.
Pass out to Kevin Nelson. Good pursuit by Tech, but look at how quick Nelson is. He was able to turn the corner. And we'll see where they mark him as out of bounds. But that freshman out of Dulles High School was run out by Leonard Jones, the rover for Texas Tech. Let's watch it again. This is actually a lateral, right, Ray?
Yeah, it's a screen, just kind of a slip screen to the tailback of the I formation. You release your tight end inside and block a linebacker, and your fullback blocks on the end man on line of scrimmage. You pitch a ball to him, and in this case it was a lateral to try to get it where he's turned up field a little bit more.
Duhon to the right, Bill Boy Bryant to the left. I formation. Hand off to the up man, Orr at the 45, and he's right at midfield. A gain of 10 and a Texas first down. Merv Skurlark makes the stop for Texas Tech, but Texas on a quick hitter up the middle to Terry Orr with a first down.
Bill, that was just a trap, and I tell you, Orr cut it behind the pulling guard and found a seam in there for a 10-yard gain.
Texas Tech moving all of their defense around. Dawson now in the game along with Brad White, Dwayne Giles, Mike Kinsey along the front. Hand off again. And that running room is just hard to come by as Brad White, number 74, came all the way over from his left tackle spot to make the tackle.
Tech went into two wide receivers. Duhon and Bill Boy Bryant were wide to the wide side of the field. Giles, the linebacker, walked out here. They had four men, actually six men, defending the run with a little cross sweep look. Great job of pursuit by the Tech defense.
Now Texas Tech brings in Mark Rothblatt, number 79. He's 6'4", 250 out of El Paso. He'll be along the front with Ronald Byers, Brad White, and Wayne Dawson. Second down and 8 for Texas. Dodge looking left, and he's got Bill Boy Bryant at the 32-yard line. It's good for a gain of 12 and another Texas first down. Roland Mitchell was defending for the Red Raiders, but that was perfect execution by the Longhorn.
Bill, that was that's a good throw, a good route by Bill Boy Bryant. I wish we could see at the bottom. He gave him a little up move and then a little post move and then broke it out, and a good throw by Dodge. Roland Mitchell is playing pretty much head up on him, a little bit outside, and he's giving him the inside route. We could look for him and try to break the post on him here in a minute. He needs some inside out help.
Bill Boy Bryant to the right. Duhon to the left. I formation, Texas first down. Hand off this time to Orr, and he gets a tough 4 or 5 yards down to the Texas Tech 25 before Dwayne Giles makes the stop for the Red Raiders.
Well, Giles is an impressive football player. He's 230 pounds plus and can run. He's really, really an impressive football player. He should be a very high draft choice.
He came into this game, the weak linebacker, Dwayne Giles, with 71 tackles, second on the Texas Tech team this year. But an effective run by Orr makes it second down and 6. That time, play was a little late in developing.
Either the center didn't get the count or everybody else just went a little bit early.
I think it might be the case that Terry Steelhammer didn't know that it was on the first sound. Steelhammer was the backup center when the season started. Gene Chilton started at center.
Well, I talked to Gene Chilton before the game. I've known him for quite a while. What an impressive young man.
Well, at 6'3", 295, you're impressive. But Paul Jeton went out with that turf toe, and they had to do some shuffling. So they moved Chilton out to left tackle, Greg Wright at left guard, and Steelhammer moved up to be the starting center.
Okay, now they've gone to the tight end in the slot here. In the past, they've used motion with it and run the sweep to it and come back away from it some. There goes Terry Orr.
So far, Ray, Texas Tech giving Terry Orr some running room. Brad Hastings on the tackle for Tech. They're concentrating, it looks like, on stopping Kevin Nelson.
Well, Terry Orr has creased them several times, trapped just the base fullback dive, and they're going to have to slow that down a little bit because now they get inside conscious and Kevin Nelson can hurt them outside.
Again, Jerry Moore shuffling the troops. Brad White checks in along with Mike Kinsey. Wayne Dawson, Roland Byers across the front line with Giles and Brad Hastings backing them up. Third down and 5. Bill Boy Bryant in motion. There's a fumble, a big scramble, and Texas Tech has it. Mike Kinsey, number 83, was the man on the spot for the Red Raiders.
He just looks like he didn't get the handle on it right there. And then the guard's pulling, and that deflects the football. He can't find it. Good job by Kinsey of getting in after the ball. Nelson dove at it, but, you know, if your quarterback doesn't get the handle and the guard pulls around, he knocks the ball even further loose, and then you've got real problems, and that's what happened there.
The second fumble in the first quarter for Texas. 4:20 left to play in the first quarter. Tech already leading by 3 from the 28-yard line. Handoff up the middle. Big running room that time for James McGowan. And June James had to tackle him, but not before McGowan scampers to about the 40, and that will be enough for a Texas Tech first down. There is a player down, and I believe that is McGowan.
Tell you what, he's been impressive, Bill. He put his head down, got his shoulder pads over, turned north-south, and ran the football.
Well, coming into this game, Robert Lewis and Timmy Smith were the big guns for Texas Tech. Freddie Wells starting at fullback. James McGowan, the freshman out of Lindale, not playing that much, but he is very impressive today.
I tell you, good job by Freddie Wells of kicking out on the outside linebacker. Look at the running there, but just ran over June James. That's just a power play, off tackle, double down, kick out.
So far, McGowan has carried 4 times for 22 yards. Also good blocking that time by the center, Jim McIntyre, and the left guard, Joe McMeans and Joe Walter. Now, Joe Walter, 6'6", 270 at left tackle for Texas Tech, and McMeans is 6'2", about 235, so
When you go up behind Joe Walter, you go up behind a big one.
Well, I tell you, I saw their Baylor ball game, and Joe Walter and then Sid Chambers. Sid is 6'6", 270. Those two guys look like two big ice boxes standing over there.
And, you know, they lost the Bizard kid earlier this year.
Right. Clovis Hale, who was on our staff last year, had told me that he thought Bizard might be the best offensive lineman in the preseason that they would have on their squad. And since they've lost him, they've had to do some shuffling. They've got good size. They're not as big as Texas up front, but they've got good size.
So coming in now will be Robert Lewis, number 27, who was supposed to be the starter in this game. And he will line up in the back of the eye. Freddie Wells will be at fullback. So here we take a look at what normally is the starting backfield for Texas Tech. Aaron Cassie barking the signals. Hand off to Lewis. And he's inside the 40 at about the 42-yard line. Steven Braggs on the tackle for Texas. Last year, Ray Auburn, Robert Lewis rushed for 126 yards on 25 carries against Texas. In fact, that's the most yardage any back had had against the Longhorns.
I tell you, he came into the game, and he was high-fiving everybody in the huddle, so he's fired up about getting his opportunity with McGowan out of the ball game.
Split backfield, second down, 8 for the Red Raiders. Cassie looking for a receiver, and he throws it out of bounds at the 50. It was intended for Troy Smith. At that time, John Hagee had pretty good coverage on him, and I thought Cassie showed some wisdom there by throwing it out of everyone's reach.
Just a sprint out of split backs. Ty Allard came upfield and put some pressure on him, made him deliver the ball a little bit before he wanted to. I think so. It's a good job of getting it away out to the outside of the field, out of bounds where it couldn't be intercepted.
Cassie came out of Ballinger, Texas, where he was an all-star quarterback in 2A football. But he's had an impressive freshman year. Boy, what a great game he had against Texas A&M for the Red Raiders. The third down, and he's in trouble now. Ralph Darnell, number 94, the man in for Texas.
Problem ahead. They had good coverage, and they brought a lot of heat from up front. No games or stunts. Didn't bring any linebackers. They just did a good job of covering with a lot of pressure.
Dennis Vance will be back on his 20-yard line to punt.
Again, a nine-man look up front.
There's Kelvin Epps, number 40. Well, he drops it. He picks it up. Now he's going to run. He's got running room. He's at the 45, the 50, and he's down in Texas territory at the 47-yard line. That was one fumble that paid dividends.
That was a scholarship run there, Bill. If he doesn't make it, it's a scholarship. I tell you what happened. Texas had a holdup on. They were trying to hold everybody up. And he fumbled the ball. They relaxed a little bit, and he took off and ran with it.
Now, Ray, Texas tried to block the first two. Had they tried to block that one, they'd have had him dead to rights.
Right, exactly. As you can see there in your picture, the guy blocking on number 35 from Texas Tech had him turned all the way around.
A gain of about 15 on the play. So a potential disaster turned into a big gain for Texas Tech.
Okay, well, stop by.
I tell you, Bill, sometimes it's better to be lucky than good.
That's you've heard that before.
Oh, yeah. I tell you, but that was a good job by Vance running the football. As I say, that could have been a scholarship deal there.
Second down now and 7 for the Red Raiders. Robert Lewis comes out. Timmy Smith has it now as he's checked into the ball game, into the 40, down to about the Texas 42-yard line. Smith and Lewis share time at the I running back position. Smith, a 6-foot, 200-pounder, a sophomore out of Hobbs, New Mexico, and boy, what an athlete he was in high school.
Yeah, very, very heavily recruited. Billy, Tech has got about a minute 20 left in this quarter. If they can get a first down, they turn and have the wind, that'll make a great deal of difference for them. He's a little bit out, I would think, out of Ricky Gann's field goal range at this point.
All right, Lewis had to check in at the last minute. Troy Smith in motion. Third down, he needs 4. He's got his man out here, and he had enough for the first down. Ty Allard was defending But it looked like he had Freddie Wells all alone down there at about the 42.
Yeah, just play action pass. They're getting you see Freddie Wells come out right behind Buzz Tatum right there, get out in the flat. Ty Allert's running behind him. The ball's delivered. He just doesn't catch it. It would have been a first down.
As they say, it hit him in a bad place, huh?
Yeah, right in the middle of the hand.
So that great run that time by Dennis Vance for naught as Texas Tech. Vance will be punting again. This time he just punts it down to the 10 if they can kill it, and he just couldn't quite get to it. That was number 50, Todd Ryden. And he tried to get to it at about inside the 5-yard line. Couldn't do it, so the ball will come out to the 20-yard line. The University of Texas will host the NCAA Swimming and Diving Championships in 1985. The nation's finest collegiate swimmers and divers will be on the Austin campus for what many consider will be the best swimming meet in 1985. All session tickets will be on sale starting January and are $30 for the entire week. That's the NCAA Swimming and Diving Championships in Austin, March the 26th through March the 31st. Ball at the 20. 54 seconds left in the quarter. Texas trailing by three. So far, the Longhorns have not been able to move the football. Good job of running by Terry Orr. Calvin Riggs wraps him up. But a gain of three on the play for the big 231-pounder out of Abilene.
Bill, Tech is going with Artis Jackson at the nose tackle, moving into an odd man front to try to mess up Texas blocking schemes. That was a trap, and Artis Jackson just stood everybody up and was able to hold his ground, allow the linebackers to come across and make the play.
Well, now Jackson's in there along with Scott Davis, David Beaudry, and Calvin Riggs. Dodge wants to throw, coming from the backside. He's almost tackled. He throws it up for grabs. Another Texas turnover.
Bill, Calvin Riggs calls that interception. He grabbed Dodge around the ankles just as he released the ball, and the ball skied on him, caused him to overstride. Look at the bottom of your screen. Calvin Riggs beats Gene Chilton up the field, comes in with his left hand, gets him right by the leg. Dodge throws the ball and causes him to look like an ante over. Throws the interception.
Well, he threw it into some heavy coverage too, as Texas Tech had that one well smelled out. And three turnovers by Texas. Two fumbles and interception in the first quarter. Only 10 seconds left to play from the 35-yard line. Cassie wants to pass. He's got a receiver downfield. Tatum's got it. At the Texas 48-yard line, Jerry Gray defending.
That's a real good call by the offensive staff.
I believe that was David Nash instead of Buzz Tatum. David Nash, the senior out of Los Angeles, California. And you told me coming up here on the plane, he's a big one at 6'4", 232.
A very fine athlete. We spent a little time with David trying to convince him to come to Rice. A very, very talented guy. Can run for a fellow his size.
That was a 17-yard pass play that time from Cassie to David Nash. First and 10. 2 seconds left to play in the first quarter. This will be the final play of the quarter. Hand off to James McGowan as he dives over left guard for about two. And that will end the first quarter of play with a score. Texas Tech 3 and Texas nothing. The Red Raiders smelling an upset in Lubbock. We'll be back with more right after this brief timeout. This is Home Sports Entertainment. Conditions for football in Lubbock, Texas.
Bill, James McGowan is going to the dressing room with the trainer and the team doctor. Can't tell, but look, he's walking fairly good, but he's got a little bit of a limp.
Robert Lewis in his place. Cassie. Big Texas rush and a fumble. Texas Tech has it, however, but the man to create all the problems, the big refrigerator, Tony DeGreat, number 99, 6'4", 280, out of Snyder, Texas.
They brought the linebackers. As you can see, the back stepped up and protected pretty well, but DeGreat broke loose. Just fortunate they were able to hold on the ball. Cassie came up limping a little bit after that play.
Got a little help that time from Tony Edwards, who's no small one at 260. Bring up third down and 17 now for Tech. Hand off to Lewis as he gets right up to about midfield before he's brought down. A gain of about three or four. And Dennis Vance will have to punt one more time. So right now, the Texas defense is doing its best to hold the offense in the game. Three turnovers for Texas in the first quarter. But, Ray, the big statistic is the fact that Tech has only been able to make 3 points out of those three turnovers.
And the thing that you do with a ball club like Texas is if you don't get to take advantage of some of those things, it's going to come back to haunt you.
This time, Texas with a little bit of a rush on. Vance punts it straight up in the air. Kelvin Epps decides, and wisely so, to let it go, but it's going to go down to the Texas four-yard line. Killed down there by Charles Jackson, a punt of 46 yards.
You've got to handle a football. You've just got to handle it.
But he got lost. He got turned around.
Now, the sun could have been a factor in that. I don't know, but you have got to handle a punt. That's two that he's let bounce, and you're going to lose yardage almost every time that happens.
You know, Todd Dodge hasn't had very good field position on any of the drives he's tried to start here.
Now they're on their 3.5-yard line going into the 25-mile-an-hour wind. Now they've definitely got their work cut out for them. They need to maintain possession of football and take it into the wind.
Beaudry, Byers, White, and Dawson along the front for Texas Tech. Wayne Giles and Brad Hastings in the game for the Red Raiders. First and 10, I formation, Terry Orr, the workhorse. Let's call it a gain of a half a yard. Byers and Hastings there about the same time, and then joined by a bunch of swarming Red Raiders. We've got a sellout crowd of 50,000 plus at Jones Stadium, and they're looking for an upset today. And as Ray told you, Texas Tech usually finds the measure of Texas on election year.
I didn't know that. My daughter pointed that out to me. She's a student out here.
Ray's daughter Shannon is a sophomore here at Texas Tech. There's a handoff to Kevin Nelson, Dwayne Giles, Gannon Hastings in on the tackle. Boy, that Brad Hastings with 71 tackles coming into the game. Giles, as you already pointed out, with 71 tackles. That's a pretty good defensive unit for Texas Tech.
Ted Giles is a really impressive looking young man on just standing there on the hoof, and then when you see him run around, he's really more impressive.
Well, here comes a penalty against Texas Tech.
I tell you, Tech is pursuing the football awfully well. Texas is going to have to do something to slow their pursuit down. They're having 7-8 guys on every play, every running play.
Somebody from Tech must have lined up offsides prior to that play. So the Longhorns have one of their bigger gains.
Right, instead of having third and about seven, it's second and 3.5. A big difference.
Power to the right side for Texas on second down and 4. Handoff. That's number 35, Jerome Johnson, but Merv Skurlark was there, the freshman out of Monahans, and they didn't fool anybody.
They've got the strength of the formation over here, pull the onside guard and block everybody down. Good job out there by Carl Carter of stacking up the pulling guard, and they made the hit on Jerome Johnson. Good play.
Big play for Texas now, trying to get out of the shadow of its own goal line. Third down and 3. Texas Tech leading by 3 in the second quarter. Handoff, and Johnson has a little trouble finding the handle. Now he does. Gets out over the 15 to the 20-yard line. A Texas first down. Good running that time by Jerome Johnson. Correction, Ray, that was Terry Orr, right?
Oh, he's having trouble hanging on to the ball down there deep in their territory. They put the strength of formation the same way and went away from it. And that's just good ball carrying.
You think if he'd have dropped that ball down there, Fred Akers may have had a small seizure.
He'd have probably been laying prone over there at the 50. They'd had the trainers working on him. And he just had to juggle a football. That's all. It looked like the handoff was smooth.
Fumble! And I believe Texas fell on it at about the 21-yard line. I think that was Jerome Johnson. Ronald Byers was there. Todd Dodge got the handle on it. Let's see it again, Ray. I believe the handoff was to the up man, 35, Jerome Johnson, and he just never got it.
Trap play, Greg Wright pull from left guard to trap. just didn't handle the football.
Kevin Nelson attracts a whole bunch of Red Raiders. Mark Rothblatt, Artis Jackson, right at the line of scrimmage.
Bill, I tell you, the Texas Tech defensive front is playing very, very well right now with their long, with their linebackers. They are swarming people.
Todd Dodge looking over to Fred Akers. We'll get to Fred Akers in a moment. One of the most fantastic coaching records in the history of the Southwest Conference. Bill Boy Bryant to the right, Duhon to the left. Third down and 12. Texas deep in its own territory at the 20. Dodge rolling right, looking for Harris, and he's dropped it at the 38-yard line. Roland Mitchell was defending for Texas Tech, but Big William Harris just could not hold on to the pigskin.
Bill, that's a great break on the football by Roland Mitchell. He came from 6 yards away and broke on the ball, and he caused that to happen. It was a good throw. It was kind of a drop back and then a half sprint or roll. Great job by Roland Mitchell breaking on the football.
Telchik will be attempting his second punt now. His first punt, as you'll remember, went the length of the field 73 yards. His previous longest punt had been 69 yards against OU. He'll be back on his five. This time, however, he'll be punting into the wind, and look at that punt, into the wind. And he forces the Texas Tech man all the way back to the 22-yard line, and he made a heck of a fair catch on it.
Yeah. John Telchik, that is just an excellent job of kicking the ball into this kind of wind. Now the Texas defense comes up with a big play here, and they're back in the hunt.
That was Bruce Perkins, a 57-yard punt from John Telchik into about a 20-mile-an-hour breeze. The key to that punt, however, he's got the point to turn over for him.
Bill, Bruce Perkins is a walk-on from Coronado here in Lubbock, and proved point of some every year somebody's overlooked.
That time, Robert Lewis tried the right side, but when you try Tony DeGrate, you better be loaded for bear, along with James McKinney. And Robert Lewis was going nowhere. Boy, what a weapon it is to have a Telchik, Ray. You just went from your own 20-yard line to the opponent's 20-yard line.
Into this doggone wind, you're thinking, most people are thinking, well, we can just get them on their side to 50. We're going to be in great shape. And here they got the ball at their 20.
Lemuel Stinson going wide to the right. Troy Smith to the left. High formation. Hand off again to Robert Lewis. And he's caught in the backfield by Tony DeGrate. DeGrate came into this game with 72 tackles. He pressured the quarterback 23 times, and he came up with 5 sacks. Those stats are All-American quality.
He's big enough to be 2 All-Americans. And they have not had much success blocking Tony so far this afternoon.
What did you tell me last week? They had to give up 2 scholarships to feed him.
Right. They're counting him twice in the Texas count.
Third down and 12. Smith in motion. Cassie back on his own 10. He wants to pass. He's got a man at the 22 to the 25. Out to about the 32-yard line goes Freddie Wells before Ralph Darnell can pull him down. And Wells is going to be close to the first down marker, maybe a little shy.
Well, that's a great play by Ralph Darnell. Had he not made that play, it was definitely a first down. It could have been a much bigger gain. A good job of Freddie Wells of juking a little bit to the outside and turn the ball up inside.
Vance will be punting now from his 15. He is averaging 37.5 in this game. He came into this contest with a 39-yard average, but he will have the wind to his back for the first time today. So a pretty good punting average into the breeze for Dennis Vance. Here come the Longhorns again.
Showing a 9-man block again.
This one may bring rain on a cloudless day. Texas again does not field the ball. It takes a Tech bounce to the 13-yard line.
Approximately a 17-yard difference. And if he would fair caught the ball, I think it was at the 30. Now the ball is at the 13.
A punt that time of 55 yards for Dennis Vance. So we are seeing a punting exhibition today between Vance and John Telchik for Texas. Telchik's going to have a pretty good average.
Yeah, this could be a clinic film. We can sell this and make money off punting clinic.
Again, the key, however, for the Red Raiders, Texas deep in its own territory at the 14-yard line, having to try to generate another drive. 8:25 left to play in the first half. Texas Tech leading. Texas 3-0. Dodge rolls left. He's got William Harris open. If he can get it to him, he can't get it to him. Whole swarm of Red Raiders led by Wayne Dawson, who is coming off the field. Number 46, a senior out of Temple, Texas, 6 foot 225. And checking in his place is Tim Crawford. There you see the first quarter, and it was all Texas Tech. However, total yards, not a big difference, but Tech does have the 3 points on the scoreboard. Second down and 11. Dodge to Kevin Nelson. Calvin Riggs comes in from his right end position to make the tackle.
Bill, in talking to the Tech coaches, Calvin Riggs is an undersized guy that's an overachiever. He's 200 pounds, maybe a little 200 plus, 2'4", 2'5". Great quickness, as you can see there. That was a big league football play by Calvin Riggs.
Ray, I have counted 8 different people used by Jerry Sloan in the first 5 people in the defense for Texas Tech. He's shuttling in his players according to whether he needs a good pass rush or to stop the run.
Right. He's moving the Artis Jackson in. Now he's got contained.
Oh, Dodge that time, threw across the middle, but there was a lot of pressure from Tim Crawford, and he made him throw too early. And the Tech defense gets a roar of approval from this 50-plus crowd at Jones Stadium. Telchik again back deep to punt. And this time he'll be standing in his own end zone.
Well, you can't say enough about the rushing of the Tech defensive lineman.
This time he gets a line drive off again. Perkins has it at the 40. Coming wide to the left. And there may be a penalty on Texas Tech at about the 47-yard line. As he returned it about 8 yards. Bruce Perkins was the man with the football, but there's a flag right there. You see it. Time Telchik punted at 48 yards. This wind is not bothering him at all.
No, it's causing him to be even a little bit, probably concentrate a little bit more. Gerard Senegal made a great play. Then he contained it, was blocked. I think that's the guy they call the clipping penalty on or the holding penalty on. Contained it and still made the play. Excellent job with their special team.
Well, they call it one of those illegal blocks where you can't block below the knees. So that'll take it back 15 yards.
Something the Tech offense did not need.
So for Texas Tech now, the Red Raiders will set up shop on their own 31-yard line. Troy Smith and Charles Simpson double out to the right side, I formation. Aaron Cassie, now he gets a pass off to Lewis at the 30-yard line. But look at June James do a great job of containment along with Ty Allert. I guess for a group, those are the best three linebackers in college football. Ty Allert, June James, and Tony Edwards. And that time you saw them in action.
If there are three better, I'd hate to play against them.
Well, they'd have to be in the pros.
Yeah, those three guys. Like, for example, on that play, James and Allert were waiting on him to turn the football up the field. See, Carlos Maynard, my old friend that coached the linebackers for us, the defensive coordinator, coach of secondary Tech now, doing a little sideline coaching.
6:13 left to play in the first half. This time, a quick pass to Lemuel Stinson, and he makes a diving catch at the 40-yard line. It'll be about a yard and a half shy of a first down for Tech. It'll bring up third down, down about 1. James Lott was defending.
Bill, this is a good job. Just a little slant against man coverage. Because of Stinson's speed, they will keep giving him some room out there, because if they start jumping up on that play, he's going to give them a pump and go on them.
Of course, a lot
really
of great
run.
Athlete, too, of course.
Oh, yeah. He can really run, Stinson.
Third
super
down
speed.
And 1. High formation for Texas Tech. Looks like Cassie may be changing the play at the line of scrimmage. I don't know if it did any good. Robert Lewis that time tried to burrow under that big Texas defensive line. Led by number 85, Blake Brawner and James McKinney. It's going to be close enough for a measurement. Cassie so far today has completed 5 of 10 passes for 40 yards. Cassie came into the game with a 52% ratio of completions, 48 of 91 for 527 yards, five touchdowns and five interceptions. They put it down, and it's a Texas Tech first down by the hair on the football.
That pig didn't have much hair on it, did it?
No, it didn't. And the wave is back in motion around Jones Stadium. They've got it down pretty good here in Lubbock.
Let's see if they go with it this time. The Texas people participate. Nope, they're going to get booed again.
First and 10. Cassie keeps it. Looking for a man to pass it to, but look who's out there, Tony Edwards. And if he can't carry that 260 pounds, senior out of St. Louis, number 63. What a load for a middle linebacker.
He was trying to get the ball to Buzz Tatum. He was well covered and got so much pressure from Edwards, he just ran the ball out of bounds.
So far, the leading rusher for Tech today has been McGowan with 44 yards, but he is in the dressing room, I believe. Good job of running so far, but he ran out of room. June James corralled Timmy Smith at about the 25-yard line. And now in four straight plays, we have mentioned June James twice, Tony Edwards once, and Ty Allert the other time. All three Texas linebackers.
Bill, I tell you, Tony Edwards actually caused the loss. He came straight up the middle, made the first hit, and then allowed James to make the play.
Today's attendance here at Jones Stadium has been announced at 50,722, capacity plus. That time, Timmy Smith trying to juke to the outside, but he couldn't get away from June James at the 30, so that tough Texas defense holds one more time. And if you are a football purist and you love your defense, you're loving this game today because you're seeing two of the better defensive displays we've seen in the Southwest Conference this year.
I tell you, the people up front, they're having a real war between the offensive and defensive fronts. That was just a sprint draw, trying to catch them coming upfield.
That was Stephen Braggs back deep for Texas, and Vance will punt one more time from about his 15-yard line. This time he hangs it high, a spiral. Fumble! A scramble for it, and a Texas Tech has it again. The third fumble in the football game for Texas. James Johnson was the man on the football for Texas Tech, and boy, are they excited at Jones Stadium.
Okay. Bill, they took Kelvin Epps out, I guess, for not catching the football. And the wind swirling may have something to do with this, although it looks like he had a fair grip on it and just dropped the football.
Well, you know, I said a moment ago when Epps was in there and he let that one go, it looked like the wind had turned him around, Ray, so
yeah.
He was a bit confused on it.
Could be a factor. Tech needs to get some points on the board in this possession.
Ball at the 35-yard line, 3:38 to play. Hand off to the front man, Freddie Wells, and he doesn't go far. And maybe that could be because of Tony DeGreat and Bill Heathcott. Blake Bronner also getting off the pile, as is Tony Edwards. A gain of about two on the play, so it'll bring up second down, 8.5. 3:15 left to play in the half. Tech leading 3-0 and trying to get some more points on the board. Texas with four turnovers, three fumbles, and one interception, but still hanging tough.
Look for the play-action pass here, Bill.
Cassie going wide, he finds a gap and he twists down to about the 26-yard line.
That's a good call. Just the option play, fake to the fullback and take the ball outside. Cassie ducked it up inside of James McKinney.
Somebody got a hold of his jersey. Had they not, Ray, he might have rumbled for about 20 more yards.
Bill, I'll tell you something else. Tony Edwards is holding his right hamstring as if he might be having some tightness there, which would be a blow to the Texas defense.
David Nash checks into the ball game now along with Troy Smith and Buzz Tatum. So you got two tight ends, I formation, third and one for Tech. Handoff and fighting his way inside the 25 was Timmy Smith.
It's going to be very, very close. I'm not sure he made it.
Tony DeGrake, Bill Hefcock, Blake Bronner in on the tackle for Texas. Well, if they give him his forward motion, let's see where he ended up. There he did. He did get, maybe got to the 24. They're going to stop and measure it. Well, they didn't give him a real good placement on that football.
That was the Texas placement.
Big, big measurement here for both teams, and it's going to come up just inches shy. The crowd, of course, wants them to go for it. Tough decision here for Jerry Moore, out to Baylor. This might be one of his toughest decisions of the year. He's going for it.
He's going to go for it. I've got to think that he doesn't figure 6 points is going to be enough to win the football game, although they're playing great defense. He gets the first down here, get a chance to get a touchdown going with a big lead at halftime.
Jerry Moore is going for it. Fourth and inches. Jerry Gray, Tony Edwards was in there, but I believe, did Cassie keep it?
Yeah, he kept it on the option, just came to the left side.
You know, what a great fake that time by Freddie Wells. That may have made that
a play. Real good job freezing the linebackers inside with a fake. Look at Wells jump in the air and turn his pads as if he had the football, and Cassie followed him on in. That's great execution by their offense.
First and 10 from the 21-yard line. 1:35 left to play in the half. Texas Tech trying to get on the scoreboard. Handoff up the middle. Goes Freddie Wells as he busts down to the Texas 11-yard line. On the quick hitter, June James Edwards on the tackle for Texas. But a 10-yard run and a Texas Tech first down.
Well, they've come option a couple of times, and all of a sudden you just hand the ball base to the fullback.
All right, there's timeout is called to move the chains. Time will start again. It now starts to tick off. 125, 124 left in the first half. Tech leading it 3-0 over Texas. Trying to get some more points on the Jones Stadium scoreboard. I formation. Wells in the game with Timmy Smith. Cassie pitches out to Smith. Cuts it inside at about the 5-yard line. And that time Smith ran over Jerry Gray, and Stephen Braggs had to make the tackle at the 5, and we haven't seen that too often this season.
Bill, I tell you, they brought Stephen Braggs inside, and Cassie saw him coming and dealt the ball off Timmy Smith, and has an excellent job of carrying an excellent job running the option.
So a timeout called by Texas Tech, 101 left to play in the first half. Tech now on the 5-yard line. We'll be back in a moment. This is Home Sports Entertainment.
This bud's for everyone who keeps things rolling in the mighty Mississippi.
Breakaway bars, breakaway bars. Please respond.
Let's get them.
This is the name of Golding. We're right below here and we're on our way out.
I'll come around to the port side and bumper there.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do, this bud's for you.
Welcome back to Jones Stadium. We've got a minute, 1 second left to play in the first half. Texas Tech taking a timeout to gather the thoughts. The ball on the 5. Let's look at that last play again, Ray Auburn.
You can see Braggs ran the stunt. Going to give you again the kind of athlete he is. There he is coming in, takes a quarterback, comes back outside, and makes a play on the pitch back.
Boy, did Timmy Smith run right over Jerry Gray that time. Wow, we haven't seen that too much.
That will not happen very often.
Aaron Cassie now has the play from Jerry Moore. So let's see what it is.
Plenty of time, Bill. They've got 2 timeouts left. Ball on the 5-yard line. They can get a first down. It'll be on about the half-yard line.
Hand off to the front man, Freddie Wells, who burrows down to about the 3. Thomas Aldridge, Tony DeGray, James McKinney on the tackle. Texas Tech has 1 timeout left, 48 seconds as the play is run in by Bruce Perkins. So I guess Tech's going to try to score with no time left, right? They've got 1 timeout left. They'll try one more play here.
If they don't make it here and they want to go for the field goal, they'll use it to set up. Could go play action here, Bill.
I formation. Third down. Handoff. fighting to about the one-yard line as Timmy Smith, Tony Edwards, makes the touchdown saving tackle for Texas. And now we have some decision-making for Jerry Moore and his staff. Of course, the offensive coordinator for Texas Tech, Tom Wilson, a good friend of yours, I know, Ray.
Yeah. Just good hard-nosed football here, Bill. Looked like Tony DeGraden may have been offsides or was in the neutral zone before the ball was snapped. Just good hard-nosed football. Run right at him. Here we come. And I think Jerry looks like he's going to go for it.
Well, he wants to measure it because, as you said, they could make a first down down on the goal line. If not, it'll be fourth and one. That might do a lot to make him make up his mind. It's a first down, Tech. First and goal from the one. 19 seconds left to play in the first half. Now, if it's a running play, Tech is going to have to line up quick if they don't make it and try it again or try a pass to stop the clock.
Stop the clock. And this is where experience, Cassie, I've been impressed with his composure to this point. Now, we'll find out a lot about him. He's going to grow up in a hurry here in the next 19 seconds.
What about a rollout coming back to your tight end, Buzz Tatum? Opposite away from the flow.
I would think that maybe they either call two plays in the huddle or else they coach Cassie again to the fact that if we don't get it in this time, you take the ball and throw it out of bounds.
Tatum and Nash, double tight ends. Troy Smith, the lone wide receiver, out to the left. Cassie looks it over, I formation. Hand off and the dive goes to Timmy Smith. Touchdown, Texas Tech. And they're going crazy in Lubbock.
Good power football, Bill.
That time, Timmy Smith goes behind the blocks of Jim McIntyre, Joe McMeans, Aubrey Richburg, and Jeff Keith. And the Red Raiders score with 15 seconds left in the first half, and the extra point could make it 10-0 Tech. We've got a big upset on our hands here. There was a flag on the play. I believe it's against the Longhorns. Yes, it is, and they'll march it off.
It's dead ball foul, Bill. It'll probably be on the kickoff. Good ball carrying there.
Ricky Gann. Will attempt the extra point for the Red Raiders. And now this crowd is beginning to sense an upset in the making here, and we might have one. It's down, it's up. And it's good. So with 15, there's a flag down, so let's hold everything. It came in the middle of the line.
Texas had 12 men on the field, Bill.
I believe Jerry Moore will be content to keep just take that extra point, don't
yeah.
you?
Yes, I do. Plus, they're going to get 15 on the kickoff with the wind. They'll be able to kick the ball out of the end zone, and or they may squib it to prevent a run back with 15 seconds left, and they'll go in the dressing room with a 10-0 lead.
So a surprise turn of events. The Texas Tech offense, or the Texas offense, I should say, has turned the football over four times in the first half. Never really got untracked. The Texas Tech defense could have a lot to do with that, however. The offense has managed to put 10 points on the board for the Red Raiders, and we may be looking at some kind of second half for you here on HSE.
This is an election year, Bill.
Well, we
that's an unbelievable stat, but it's an election year.
A score just announced to us moments ago, a final score. The amazing TCU Horned Frogs under Jim Wacker continue their winning ways, defeating the University of Houston 21-14 today. TCU takes on Texas Tech next week, and then Texas has to come to Fort Worth to play the Horned Frogs in 2 weeks. We will have that game for you here on HSE. Two 15-yard penalties.